Body Double is a 1984 erotic thriller directed by Brian DePalma and starring Craig Wasson, Gregg Henry, Melanie Griffith, Deborah Shelton, Guy Boyd, Dennis Franz, and Barbara Crampton. Jake Sully is having a bad day. After having a claustrophobic breakdown on the set, the actor goes home to find his lady riding some other guy in their apartment. What's that called? Cuckold? Whatever. He goes to the bar to get loaded.
Carol. I thought you were a bartender, not a priest.
That's right. I'm a bartender.
And keep the fucking glass filled.
And ends up sleeping at a ride at Walt Disney World. Jesus, he might as well sleep in a suitcase. If this shot doesn't scream forever alone, I don't know what the hell does. He meets Sam, a fellow actor, and they become fast friends. Sam, sensing Jake's dilemma and having to head to Seattle, enlists his new buddy to cover for him in his house-sitting gig. Look at this place. Like this movie, the 1980s just took a shit all over it. Sam also introduces Jake into the role of neighborhood peeping Tom.
I'd like you to meet my favorite neighbor.
Okay.
See her?
Whoa.
Try not to knock the telescope over with your boner, pal. That's some sweet neon. Jake gets bored, goes to peep some more, only to witness a break-in and some 1980s domestic violence.
Bastard.
Nice job calling the cops, hero. Jake finds out he got fired because, hey, it's Hollywood.
Fuck around with a claustrophobic vampire who freezes every time he lies down in a coffin, right? No, then what happened? What, stage fright?
Why do I get the feeling that Dennis Franz is just playing Brian DePalma here? After another hard day of getting shit on, Jake returns home to get an eyeful, only to discover that he has some competition for the Neighborhood Perv Award. Oh yeah, Jake, you have a lot of room to be disgusted, you fucking perv. The dancing neighbor winds up cutting Jake off as our Native American welder from the night before follows her, leading to a convoy through the greater LA area, winding up at the mall because it's the fucking 80s!
I'll wear something special. You'll see.
Yeah. Okay. Bye.
Nice payphone move, Jake. Jake and the competition stalk this poor woman throughout the mall. If the payphone gag wasn't enough, the idea that discretion may not be Jake's cup of tea comes up as he watches her change her panties in a dressing room. So tell me again who the threat is in this situation. The clerk calls the mall pervert patrol, who arrives bearing a sweet mustache. Jake and his neighbor wind up in a never-ending elevator ride because we have to work in the claustrophobia, sneaking by Mr. Moisturizer by using clown car antics. Once again, who's the threat here? Jake is stealing used panties from the garbage. Maybe this Native American guy is, trying to be protective. Fucking pervert. He follows her to a beachfront motel, making no effort to hide himself, because once again with Jake, it's fuck discretion! They finally communicate with each other, unless you count Jake getting a boner to her grinding, and our other creepy dude finally does something to make him look like the bad guy. Jesse Owens, this is not. I also notice that no one else is trying to stop this guy. Claustrophobia hits again and we're treated to this. That is the call of the leather-bound, purse-snatching peeper, native to Southern California.
Oh.
Anybody here a Hitchcock fan? Wow, that me masturbating to you in my window with a telescope worked! While peeping yet again, Jake spots his pal trying to break into a safe in Gloria's apartment. Jake tries to call her and we find out why phones went cordless.
God!
They decide to nap for a while Jake takes the longest fucking route to her house to be a hero. Seriously, why can't you run across a fucking vacant lot? This film becomes an ad for Hildy as Jake breaks in the door only to be attacked by the dog. Meanwhile, Gloria is getting drilled upstairs. That's coming out of her deposit. Jake talks to the cops, which comes to a crescendo in which they discover Gloria's used panties in his pocket.
What's this?
Pants, some underpants.
Yours?
No.
After a depressing day of being a useless fucking failure, Jake heads home to enjoy a night with his good friend Pornography. He notices a porn star named Holly Body doing the same dance he had been jerking off to for the last couple of days.
Now playing at the X Cinema.
Porn theaters. That has to be the most retro thing in this movie.
For you home viewers, you can pick it up right now at Tower Records All Night Video Sale.
Nope! It's Tower fucking Records. To solve the mystery, Jake decides to get in the porno business. Why the hell not at this point in your fucking miserable life? He bangs Holly in the shitter, and then Jake goes full porn star and bullshits Holly into believing he's also a producer, wanting her for a new movie. They go back to the house where she confirms that it was indeed her, dancing across the way.
Holly does Hollywood, and he wanted to hire me to do it in private because he said that he had this friend who got off on peeping.
Oh shit, someone's peeping back! Holly splits as Jake explains the entire plot to the audience. Police.
But the reason it hasn't panned out is because of your testimony that Gloria was killed by an Indian.
Well, that's just it, don't you see? That's what he wanted. It looks like a burglary, but it's a murder with me set up to be the witness. Alexander Revelle's alibi.
She gets picked up by Mr. Driller, knocked out, taken away as Jake follows. There's some horseplay leading to the makeup removal, revealing... And he probably would have gotten away with it too, if it hadn't been for the snooping masturbator. But then we have claustrophobia, and Jake is able to rise to the challenge and save the day!
So melodramatic.
Kill! Kill! No!
Oh, the dog is actually the hero. Yeah. Jake fucking sucks. So in the end, Jake gets his job back, and I guess the girl. And he lived happily ever after. Until the internet destroyed Holly's career and the entire porn industry. Body Double is an effective thriller that entertains the audience. The problem is, it really borrows a lot from Alfred Hitchcock. And I mean, in the borrowing sense, Brian DePalma went into Hitchcock's house and fucking robbed him blind. A homage is one thing, but it really sinks trying to get into the film because everywhere you turn, hey, that's fucking Hitchcock! True, DePalma made a good movie and this is a good movie. And I don't mind a little wink to the audience, but I don't want a whole smorgasbord of winks like, hey, remember this movie? Hey, remember that movie? Body Double is a superior erotic thriller of the era. And if you're not familiar with Alfred Hitchcock, you should be good to go. Otherwise, the whole specter of the master of suspense may weigh on your viewing enjoyment.
I like to watch. Makes you hot, doesn't it? Yeah. Makes me hot too, real hot. Come over here. Show you how hot.
No, I don't.